Thara.
And Goutham.
Together we are called Clueless Compass. So we started our journey together literally and figuratively 4.5 years ago. So our first trip was to Kashmir in 2014. And then we have been traveling together ever since then. We have covered around 20 states in India and about 17 countries. We started writing about our travels in 2016. We started off with writing for various travel magazines, and that garnered a lot of attention, and we got a lot of appreciation for our travel articles. So that actually made us think about a travel blog, and we started sharing our experiences on social media in 2018 January through our Instagram page called Clueless Compass, and we got tremendous response from our followers. That made us start a Facebook page and a blog 6 months later, and we have been writing and sharing pictures of our travels for about 1.5 years now. And another thing is, last week we started our first YouTube video, that is first vlog as we call it. So yeah, we started our YouTube channel also last week. So that's about the journey of Clueless Compass.
A favorite place? I think this is one answer we would both agree on. Our favorite city so far is Istanbul. Istanbul, the capital city of Turkey. We were there for 4 days. We went there in 2017, and we explored the city by foot. Maybe that could be one reason we feel that city was special, because we explored explored completely by foot. And about Istanbul, Istanbul is a city where two cultures, two diverse cultures meet. Half of the city is in Asian continent, and the other half is in Europe. So that means there is an amalgamation of two different cultures, and that shows in everything, like their their music, their culture, their food, everything. So we were very happy that we could explore and experience a diverse culture in 4 days. We could see the Sufi dance, whirling dervishes dancing. We could experience their musical culture, which is amazing, and the cuisine. It's like not like, like.
So nowadays we see a lot of youngsters getting scared at the thought of marriage. They feel that the marriage is going to change their freedom or easy way of living, or their journeys, travels. But it's not always true. See, if you find a partner who shares your passion for travel, maybe your life is going to get more eventful after your marriage. From my experience, I am saying, traveling as a couple has its own benefits. One thing I could say is regarding these emergencies. When you are traveling and if your health gets deteriorated, or if some accident happens, there is always someone dependable right next to you who could take care of the situation, whom you can trust. That is a big advantage of traveling as a couple rather than traveling solo. The other thing is that traveling as a couple actually increases the bond between your partner. See, when you are traveling, you are always together. 24/7 you are together actually. So that much quality time will, you know, let you know more about your partner. This won't happen when, you know, during daytime you are going to work, come back after office hours, tired, and you don't get to spend too much quality time together. But when you are traveling, in that setting of adventure, and your partner is always together, I don't think there is any better way to, you know, build a relationship between two people.
Everyone loves to travel. Like, there are, you know, I don't know, there are very few people who wouldn't want to travel. But does everyone travel? Most of the people don't travel because of self-doubt. Like, they're confused whether to, you know, save money, invest money, or to spend money for travel. So there is always this confusion going on in, you know, people's mind. Like, we get a lot of questions like that. So do you spend all your money for travels? Don't you guys save anything? Don't you guys want to own a house? So yeah, priorities matter. So at the moment our priority is, first priority is travel. So we spend most of our money, all of it for travel. So something I want to say to people who want to travel is to break yourself doubt, get your priorities straight, plan well, research well, and save a small amount of money judiciously every month for your travel plans. Then travel is very much possible for all of us.
There are a lot of people who takes traveling as a career, but we are not full-time travelers. We have our own jobs here and we travel during our holidays. Currently, we try to sandwich a common holidays, public holidays and weekends in between, and take one or two leaves in between so that we'll get 8 or 9 days together, and we use that for traveling, like our Christmas holidays or our festival holidays like that. That's how we find time to travel even though we are working. We have actually written a blog article which, you know, helps people or give tips to people who have full-time jobs and still wants to travel cheaply on a budget. So yeah, we are not full-time travelers.
As I said earlier, we are very active on social media. We go by the name Clueless Compass in all our social media handles. So we have an account in the name Clueless Compass on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, and we have a bilingual blog in English and Malayalam, which is again goes by the same name, www.cluelesscompass.com. So you can check us out in all these handles, and make sure you read our blog also.
Follow and subscribe also, so that you get to read all the travel stories.